Accompaniments in the form of pickles and chips form an integral part of the Onam Sadhya. Shakkara Varatti, a nice combination of bananas which are deep fried and then coated in a jaggery syrup and spice powders. Yes, Shakkara Varatti is what we are going to learn today on Dakshin Curry from Preetha. That's me. But before we get on to the recipe, do not forget to click on the bell icon for notifications. Before we get on to the recipe, let's quickly take a screenshot of the ingredients needed to make Shakkara Varatti. That way, whenever you want to make it, you know what to use. So this recipe is going to be done in two steps. One is frying of the bananas, and likewise, we are going to be preparing a jaggery syrup and then assembling the whole thing together. So let's start with deep fat frying. I'm using coconut oil, so ensure you use only that. And I have these Nendran bananas, which are the unripe ones or semi-ripe. You can use those. So I'm going to now add all the pieces. Be careful whenever you are using hot oil. Once you add this, we are going to fry this on a medium flame. Or rather, the oil is very hot, from a medium to a lower flame, till these turn nice and crisp and golden brown. So now while these are frying, just to save time, what we are also going to do is dissolve the jaggery. So in this, I'm going to add very little water. And along with that, we'll add jaggery. Now the idea is to dissolve the jaggery, till we are waiting for the banana chips to get deep fried. Just mix this up and allow it to dissolve. So if you want, you can keep this on a little lower flame. Now you can see that these are already starting to float on top. So our jaggery has dissolved and it's starting to bubble. We don't want to cook this right now. So I'm going to switch this off and get back to the chips. Now this has fried really well. I'm going to switch off the flame and we'll remove this onto a plate. As you can see, the color is nice and dark, but at the same time it's not burnt. So if you want, halfway through you can just remove one chip and also try it out. It has to be nicely crisp. Now, all we need to do is clear this area and get on to the next step. So getting on to the next step, we have our dissolved jaggery, but we need to cook this till it turns into a one string consistency. So let's do that. So right now this is just dissolved. We need to still cook it a bit. As you can see, this is a dropping consistency right now. You know, it's kind of runny. We want it to form a kind of a one string consistency. That means the droplet should not fall off very fast. We need to wait for that. So this needs a little bit more cooking. As you can see, this is not as runny as before. And also, you're getting that one string consistency. And at this stage, I'm going to quickly add the fried bananas. So add the entire lot and coat this evenly. Now it's just a matter of patience, time and effort. All you need to do is keep on mixing this evenly till it gets coated well. At this stage, we also add the spice powders. Now the main spice to add in this is the dried ginger powder. Okay, so a good quantity of dried ginger powder goes in this. Little bit of cardamom powder and little bit of cumin seed powder. And after adding all this, just going to mix this up You can also add the dried ginger powder towards the end. I just wanted to absorb the flavor, which is why I'm going to add it at this stage. So as you can see, this has thickened up nicely. At this stage, I'm going to switch off the flame and add a few spoons of roasted rice flour. Mix this. At this stage, I'm also going to add a little bit of sugar. And along with that, the remaining dry ginger powder. So let's keep mixing this till this entire mixture becomes nice and dry. So I've kept on mixing for a good 7 to 10 minutes, and after that, as you can see, this become nice and dry. I also added little more of rice flour and some powdered sugar. Like I said, don't add too much of rice flour right towards the start. Add it as and when required. So as you can see, it dries up, and even if it kind of sticks together, it's easy to break the pieces. So this is what Shakkara Varatti looks like. I hope that you make it for Onam this time as an accompaniment for your sadhya. If you have liked watching this video, do click on the like button, share the recipe, and do not forget to subscribe to India Food Network.